I'm rolling.
All right. Well, my friends, I wrote this letter for the organization Common Dreams because I like what they do, and I wanted to be included, and I wrote this letter. Let's see, and I'm going to try a teleprompter. And I hope they like this. My writings are on the website, transcendia.org, or on my wiki, Transcendia Wiki. It's our wiki. Garth put it together. And I want this to maybe go there. I want the reporters to look up Transcendia. And I've been putting little videos on the founder of Transcendia Facebook page because I could. And it has street traffic, and I need street traffic. I've got pathetic numbers on my old website, transcendia.org. I got angry at Rachel Maddow for thinking Herman Cain was funny as an art project, as a serious political artist. I'm intent on making systems that work. They're engineered to work for my people. If Herman Cain is a political artist, he's a bad one. My focus on creating a secure airport port system is an international imperative. The struggle with Islamic fundamentalists replicates Muhammad's bands of thieves that robbed merchants on the Silk Road. Civilization is diminished in your face when you go to the airport. It doesn't have to be that way. I want my passport to give you what you expect from a company like American Automobile Association and the Screen Actors Guild. They take care of their people. It works good. Nations about defense and education. You can get the gist of what I envision from reading the operational inspirations and ideal goals from the introductory pages and back pages of the Transcendian Passport on transcendia.wiki.com. The application is on transcendia.org. I look good, but there is no money coming in. I'm owed $3.54 by Google for allowing the ads they put on my website. So things have got to get better if I'm going to do what I got to do. In the U.S. now, I'm working to pull engineers and talent together. There's going to be an engineers and talent party, and the focus is going to be on the power grid as an international defense imperative and jobs program. Civilization depends on excess power, and while water wars are on the horizon, dealing with that becomes a power issue when people are ready to ruin more of the water to get natural gas. Mechanical control redundancy is required for defense of the U.S. and North American power grid, because the Chinese are serious about being able to shut down the U.S. power grid if they have a beef. And they are good hackers. In fact, we are in an economic war with China, characterized by theft of technology and significant research development. We, the U.S., successfully stopped the Soviet Union from having their spies steal all our work when Vetrov gave the French intelligence service and its ally, the U.S., 140 spies at once. Since they shot Vetrov as a traitor, well, we didn't have to protect our asset anymore. That's how the U.S. won the Cold War. We do a lot of business with the Chinese, and you are more likely to go to war with people you do business with. Now, the power grid, that's my U.S. party platform. As far as Transcendia as a nation of international ports and airports and passport offices, that's about fully realized everywhere food distribution networks. Since it's flawed, the networks mean starvation for many. In a real way, what I have put together represents the lifeboat. Certainly, labor needs mobility. Hell, you study Haiti for a while and see it might as well be a prison island. Every neighbor nation works to keep Haitians on. The U.S. is getting a so-called democracy like theirs. But aliens from outer space aren't going to show up with bottled water when suitcase nukes smuggled with drugs or by drug smugglers go off in New York City. Afghanistan is really just another hot spot in the international drug war. The people in power don't want good roads, like smuggling pilots fly loads in the worst weather. I do need to do a little rewrite of the passport, the Transcendian passport, but you'll want one. We are all required to be espionage agents and experts, and no spycraft anymore. Every spy needs more than one passport, and a U.S. passport may be a liability in many situations. I encourage you to go to transcendia.org and buy a black hat. That'll help me out, or you can buy my book about what the revolution felt like. Homeless Dog. It's an e-book. It didn't use up any paper, but sometimes I send out covers I print out. They'll be valuable collector's items one day. Homeless Dog, yeah, that's my fiction, but every political artist has to write a book. So I wrote that one, we put that one out. It's a heavy-duty fiction book. It'll scare you a little bit if you're an anarchist, because anarchy can lead to isolation. Thank you for watching.